Eddie Reynoso, the trainer and manager of Saul Canelo Alvarez, major win yesterday, leading Canelo to victory, to being the first Mexican ever to be undisputed, first undisputed ever super middleweight champion in history. Eddie Reynoso is also trainer of the year 2021, and I'll break it all down. And he's also manager of the year. So on my Twitter, at Secback, or numbers, this is the year Eddie Reynoso has had. 3 wins with Canelo, all championship fights, undisputed. A win with Ryan Garcia way back January against Luke Campbell with that vicious body shot. That was a nice win. 2 wins with Frank Sanchez, Nagy Aguilera, and of course Efe Ajagba, which most people didn't think that Frank would win. And he dominated and won clearly. A win last night with Joselito Velasquez. A win with Andy Ruiz over Chris Arreola, and 2 big wins with Oscar Valdez. One going back way to February where Oscar Valdez beat Miguel Burchett, stopped him. No one thought that was possible before. No one gave Valdez a shot. Everyone picked against him. I told people it was a 50-50 fight. Told people Valdez could pull it off. And sure enough, he pulled it off. So that was Eddie Reynoso. As the coach of the year, he had a better year than anyone else. You guys tell me, who can even come a close second? Not this year. This year, nobody. There's no competition with Trainer of the Year. And you can't give Trainer of the Year for one person who just had 1 win. Lomachenko's dad, 1 win with Usyk. But then again, he may have been the favorite going into the Joshua fight. Or Ugas Pacquiao on a 9-day notice. It's a notable win, but it may be not enough to win Trainer of the Year off just 1 win. Another notable win, Ben Davidson, big win with Josh Taylor over Jose Ramirez. But when it comes to, that's trainers of the year. Now, manager of the year, I got to give it to Eddie Reynoso. The Canelo, the superstar, the face of boxing. We're used to superstars fighting once, maybe twice a year. Canelo fought 3 times this year. All major fights, all events, all star-studded and guided him to undisputed in a beautiful way, both as a trainer and the manager. Canelo definitely fighter of the year, Eddie Reynoso trainer of the year, and manager of the year. That's how I see it. And let's see what happens. So there you have it. Stay tuned. Congratulations to Canelo and Eddie and Chepo, of course, on the great success. And I have to say this. To me, Eddie Reynoso is a great coach. And I'll explain to you why. He took Canelo in at a very young age. Never threw a jab. Made him pound for pound king. Robert Garcia has made champions from Mikey to Joshua Franco to kids that have turned pro with him. Some Mikey, obviously, from the amateurs. Joe Goosen has done it with Rafael Reyes from 12 years old, never throwing a punch, world champion. Something, for example, that Freddie Roach has never done. He's never taken a kid that never threw a jab and turned him into a champion. And that's not easy to do. So props to Angel Garcia. Props to all the dads out there, all the coaches that invest in their kids. When there's no money in the amateurs, there's no fame, there's no glory, there's no big reward except like a plastic trophy, a belt. But they invest the time, money, and effort going on the road, sleeping in a van, or camping up 6-8 people in a hotel room just so they could make it to the tournaments and make their kids champions or make the youth that they're working with champions. So Virgil Hunter did it with Andre Ward. A lot of great trainers, so Emmanuel Stewart has done it, but not everyone can do it. So Eddie Reynoso has done it, and it just shows that he's a great teacher to take someone from. It's easy to take someone with 2-3 championships and then, you know, guide him from there because they're already established, already know. It's harder to take someone that never did it, never laced them up, never shadow boxed, never knew how to stand. I'm sure the satisfaction is also much greater when you could do it from scratch. I'm sure there's no feeling like it. Like, as the Virgil Hunter told me once, from the root to the fruit. And Eddie Reynoso did it. And you can see the level of loyalty. Like, Canelo has stayed with Eddie this whole time. Even though I remember there were times where people would whisper in his ear and all the media criticized Eddie. And they were all like, oh, he needs this, he needs that. Guess what? He didn't need anything. He stuck with his guys, stuck with his team, their family. They don't have, when they say their family, they really mean it. It's not just the word they threw out there. They look out for each other. They care about each other. And they're a very, very winning team. So there you have it. FiusNewsReporting.com. I'm Malisek back reporting.